Welcome to Are You at Risk for Deadly Blood Pressure Complications with Diabetes? In this video, we will be exploring the potential dangers and complications that can arise if an individual with diabetes also suffers from hypertension, aka high blood pressure. Did you know that an estimated 1.28 billion adults between the ages of 30 and 79 have hypertension? And less than half of adults with hypertension are properly diagnosed and treated for this grave condition. Hypertension can create a dangerously long list of serious consequences for your health, including heart attacks, aneurysms, and even blindness. But if you already have diabetes, are you also at an increased risk of developing high blood pressure and its complications? And what if you already have high blood pressure? Can that lead to elevated blood sugar? We're about to explore the connection between your blood sugar and your blood pressure. What exactly is blood pressure anyway? And what does it have to do with diabetes? What are the initial symptoms of high blood pressure to watch out for? Can having diabetes actually increase the damage of hypertension? And what can you do to improve your blood sugar and your blood pressure all at the same time? Stay tuned as we delve deeper into this critical topic. We're revealing the truth of hypertension and the 8 best methods for reducing your risk of high blood pressure. And stick around to the end of this video to discover the best foods for improving your blood pressure and your blood sugar. Now, are you at risk for deadly blood pressure complications with diabetes? So, first off, what is blood pressure? Blood pressure is the force of blood pushing against the walls of your arteries as it circulates through your body. The more blood your heart pumps and the narrower your arteries are, the higher your blood pressure will be. And when the force of blood against your arteries remains consistently high, it can lead to long-term damage to your heart, blood vessels, and many other organs inside your body. This is why your doctor wants to check your blood pressure regularly. That reading is measured in millimeters of mercury, and it is recorded as 2 numbers. Systolic pressure, which signifies the pressure in your arteries when your heart is beating, and diastolic pressure, which shows the pressure in your arteries when your heart relaxes in between beats. A normal blood pressure reading is 120 millimeters of mercury of systolic pressure or lower, and 80 millimeters of mercury of diastolic pressure or lower. Doctors read these 2 numbers as 120 over 80, but it is written like this. For context, hypertension is considered to be a blood pressure reading of 140 over 90 or above. So, can having diabetes increase your risk of hypertension? And is there a flip side? Can having high blood pressure increase your risk of diabetes? The answer is just ahead. But first, you may be wondering, what are the early warning signs and main indicators of high blood pressure I should be aware of? Well, let's look closer at the symptoms of hypertension. In general, the most common early warning signs of high blood pressure include headaches, dizziness, blurred vision, chest pain, shortness of breath, a lack of good sleep, chronic nausea and vomiting, and even nosebleeds. And studies show that chronic high blood pressure, over time, can harden and thicken your arteries, eventually leading to coronary artery disease. Having high blood pressure also forces your heart to work harder, which may cause the left ventricle, the lower left heart chamber, to thicken and enlarge. But it's not just your heart which may suffer with elevated blood pressure. Hypertension can also cause blood clots and other damage in arteries, leading to your brain. All told, suffering from chronic high blood pressure can result in a host of deadly serious consequences, including vision loss, aneurysms, kidney damage, metabolic syndrome, changes with memory, understanding, and an increased risk of dementia, transient ischemic attacks, otherwise known as mini strokes, plus major strokes, heart attacks, and heart failure. So it's easy to see why your doctor regularly checks for signs of hypertension. But if you are diagnosed with chronic high blood pressure, hopefully your doctor will also explain the answer to what would no doubt be your next question. What leads to hypertension? There are many reasons why a seemingly healthy person may still experience high blood pressure. In fact, did you know that certain pharmaceuticals, including some birth control medications, cold remedies, and decongestants, may unintentionally heighten your blood pressure? But in most cases, the causes of high blood pressure are strikingly similar to the causes behind developing type 2 diabetes. Unfortunately, one contributor to hypertension is something you have zero control over: your genetics. Studies on twins and families have shown that genetic factors account for approximately 30% to 50% of the variation in blood pressure levels. Researchers have identified several specific genes that are associated with the renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system, or RAS. RAS plays a crucial role in regulating your blood pressure, as it controls the balance of fluid and salt in your body. One of the most well-studied genes involved in this system is the angiotensinogen gene, or AGT. AGT is involved in the production of angiotensin II, a hormone that constricts blood vessels and increases blood pressure. You may inherit a genetic variant of AGT, which can contribute to heightened blood pressure levels inside your body. Another gene which has been implicated in hypertension is the endothelial nitric oxide synthase gene, or ENOS. This gene helps produce nitric oxide, a molecule that relaxes blood vessels. And some families pass down genetic variants of the ENOS gene, which can lead to an increased risk of hypertension. Scientists have also found other genes associated with hypertension, including the epithelial sodium channel gene and the sodium chloride cotransporter gene, each of which are involved in salt balance inside your body. But the reality is that hypertension is a multifactorial disorder, meaning that it is not simply your family history which will determine your risk of developing hypertension. Environmental factors play a huge role for your blood pressure, and they include an unhealthy diet, a lack of physical activity, chronic stress levels, excessive alcohol consumption, and smoking. So, yes, you can still take concrete steps to reduce your risk of hypertension. But what are the exact methods for taking charge of your blood pressure? Stick around, we're revealing the best foods and proven steps to take outside of the kitchen for achieving lower blood pressure. But first, let's investigate the links between high blood sugar and high blood pressure. High blood pressure, on its own, forces your heart to work harder than normal. However, having diabetes can put even more strain on your heart and your cardiovascular system. Hyperglycemia can damage the endothelial lining of smaller blood vessels, leading to decreased blood flow and impaired vascular function. And when smaller blood vessels become compromised, it can cause larger arteries to stiffen and narrow. This puts more pressure on your heart to pump oxygen and other essential nutrients efficiently through your body. Meanwhile, a main symptom of diabetes is increased insulin resistance, where your muscle cells become less responsive to your insulin. Insulin resistance can lead your body to produce extra insulin, and increased insulin production can cause sodium retention in your kidneys. Studies show that, in the presence of insulin resistance, sodium retention is a major contributor to elevated blood pressure. Plus, while insulin is mostly known for its role in glucose management, this hormone is also involved in your body's blood pressure regulation. Insulin helps control blood pressure by promoting the release of nitric oxide, which, as we previously discussed, allows blood vessels to relax and widen. While this action, known as vasodilation, reduces the resistance to blood flow, thus lowering blood pressure, an imbalance of insulin in your body can lead to vasoconstriction, or the narrowing of blood vessels. Insulin resistance has also been found to lead to elevated cholesterol levels, which can cause arterial plaque buildup, further increasing the risk of hypertension. Additionally, as is the case with some genetic variants, hyperglycemia can activate the renin-angiotensin-aldosterone system, the hormonal pathway which regulates blood pressure. When RAS becomes overactive, it can lead to a release of renin, a hormone that increases blood pressure. Excess renin can also cause overproduction of the hormone angiotensin II, which, as we've already shown, constricts blood vessels, which can also heighten blood pressure. Furthermore, chronic high blood sugar has also been found to increase inflammation in the body. This can also damage blood vessels, further increasing the risk of hypertension. Plus, another main cause of hypertension is already having chronic kidney disease, which is a major diabetes-related medical issue. In fact, studies show that approximately 1 in 3 adult diabetics also suffers from CKD. CKD can lead to decreased filtration and elimination of salt and water, which can increase blood volume and blood pressure. Plus, chronic kidney disease, like hyperglycemia itself, can cause an overactivation of RAS, which can lead to overproduction of blood vessel constricting, blood pressure increasing renin and angiotensin II. CKD also leads to an accumulation of waste products in the body, such as urea and creatinine. Excessive levels of these toxins can also damage blood vessels and lead to inflammation, further contributing to the development of hypertension. Also, did you know that diabetes can increase the risk of sleep apnea? This condition causes disruptions to nighttime breathing patterns, and it has been found to elevate blood pressure levels during sleep. Studies show that upwards of 48% of adult type 2 diabetics have also been classified with sleep apnea, and other studies suggest that over 85% of obese type 2 diabetics suffer from this blood pressure heightening disorder. So, yes, it is plain to see that having diabetes can increase your risk of hypertension. But is there a flip side? Can having high blood pressure lead to high blood sugar? Well, the short answer is, sort of. While having high blood pressure alone won't necessarily cause you to become diabetic, there is a bi-directional relationship between diabetes and hypertension. Studies show that chronic high blood pressure can damage blood vessels in the kidneys. In turn, the kidneys can lose the ability to efficiently filter out waste products, including glucose. So, high blood pressure can contribute to elevated blood sugar, which over time can further heighten your blood pressure. In the end, studies show that nearly 75% of adult diabetics also suffer from hypertension, and the risk of hypertension increases with age, duration of a diabetes diagnosis, and a higher body mass index. A study published in the journal Diabetes Care found that type 2 diabetics were twice as likely to develop hypertension than non-diabetics. The Diabetes Care study also noted that type 2 diabetics with chronically elevated blood sugar levels and higher insulin resistance were more likely to have hypertension than those with less insulin resistance and better glucose control. So, after knowing all this, you are probably wondering, what can I do to lower my risk of hypertension? We've got the methods and the foods to help you achieve lower blood pressure and improved insulin sensitivity. But first, we're giving away 3 free gifts. Take your diabetes fighting game to a whole new level with Superfoods for Diabetics, Episode 1 of that diabetes documentary, and our groundbreaking cookbook, Snacks, Meals, and Desserts That Lower Blood Sugar. Grab each of these blood sugar balancing tools for free. Just click the link in the description box below. Okay, let's take the pressure off here. It's finally time to look into how to defeat hyperglycemia and hypertension all at once. Studies show that reducing your insulin resistance can work to decrease your blood pressure. Having lower levels of insulin will help your kidneys excrete more sodium instead of retaining that extra salt, and this can directly result in lower blood pressure levels. Plus, the American College of Cardiology found that type 2 diabetics with lower fasting blood sugar levels had significantly less risk of developing hypertension than those with higher fasting blood sugar levels. And as it turns out, many of the same methods for lowering your blood sugar can work to lower your blood pressure. So, here are 8 proven steps for reducing blood sugar and blood pressure. Number 1. Exercise regularly. Just 30 minutes of moderate physical activity per day has been found to work wonders for your blood sugar levels and your blood pressure. In fact, research shows that regular exercise can strengthen your heart and reduce your blood pressure by 5 to 8 millimeters of mercury. Number 2. Reduce your sodium intake. While the effect of salt intake on blood pressure varies from person to person, in general, doctors recommend limiting your daily dose of sodium to 2,300 milligrams. And older adults are often told to cut their intake down to just 1,500 milligrams. Research shows that even a small reduction in your salt consumption can lower your blood pressure by 5 millimeters of mercury. Number 3. Reduce your sugar intake. While high salt in the diet is a major contributor to hypertension, studies show that consuming high amounts of sugar and carbohydrates may actually be even worse for your blood pressure. Research suggests that switching to a lower-carb diet for 6 months can reduce systolic blood pressure by 3 millimeters of mercury and diastolic pressure by 5 millimeters of mercury. Number 4. Limit your alcohol consumption. Studies show that excessive alcohol consumption can raise blood pressure and reduce the effectiveness of blood pressure medications. But limiting your alcohol intake, even to just one drink per day, has been shown to lower blood pressure by about 4 millimeters of mercury. Number 5. If you smoke, quit. It's important to break free from a smoking habit for many reasons, but studies show that each single cigarette smoked can cause a temporary rise in blood pressure, as nicotine stimulates the release of blood pressure-increasing hormones like epinephrine and norepinephrine. And of course, smoking increases the formation of plaque in your arteries, which can also raise your blood pressure. Number 6. Manage your stress and improve your sleep. Research shows that chronic stress and regularly getting less than 6 hours of sleep per night can heighten your blood pressure. While more research is needed, in general, doctors believe that stress management techniques, like yoga and meditation, along with getting quality sleep, can work to reduce your risk of hypertension. Number 7. Lower your BMI. Studies show that extra weight, especially around the waistline, can increase the risk of hypertension, but losing even a small amount of weight can go a long way towards reducing your blood pressure. Research suggests that your blood pressure can lower by 1 millimeter of mercury for every 2 pounds you shed. Number 8. Eat a balanced, high-fiber, nutrient-rich diet. Yep, it's perhaps the most obvious and most important method for lowering your blood pressure. Regularly consuming whole grains, a small portion of fresh fruits, a high amount of vegetables, foods with unsaturated fatty acids, and lean or plant-based protein has been found to reduce blood pressure by up to 11 millimeters of mercury. And this naturally brings us to some great foods for lowering blood pressure. Try garlic, which supplies many anti-diabetes, pro-heart nutrients, perhaps most notably allicin. This compound has been found to relax and dilate blood vessels. Bananas, which are high in potassium, an antioxidant that has been found to reduce blood pressure. In fact, studies show that eating 2 bananas per day may decrease blood pressure by 10%. Black beans, which also give you an excellent portion of potassium to help relax blood vessels. Sweet potatoes, a lower starch, diabetic-friendly carb option, which also contains blood pressure-regulating micronutrients, namely potassium and magnesium. Kale, a high-fiber leafy green, which contains a wealth of blood sugar and blood pressure-regulating nutrients, specifically magnesium, potassium, and vitamin C. Salmon, a diabetic-friendly lean protein option that is also famous for its supply of heart-aiding omega-3 fatty acids. These fats have been found to decrease damage to cells in the walls of blood vessels, thus lowering the risk of hypertension. And even dark chocolate. Consuming a modest 50 calories worth of dark chocolate daily has been shown to reduce high blood pressure, thanks to its supply of the antioxidant flavanol. So, now you know. Hypertension and hyperglycemia go hand in hand, but there are steps you can take to lower your blood sugar and your blood pressure. What did you think of today's topic? How do you go about lowering your blood pressure? Comment below to let us know. Don't forget to grab your 3 free gifts by clicking the link below, and please hit those like and subscribe buttons. To really show your appreciation for Diabetes Smarts, you can click the thanks button.